All right, so it's basically done. I don't think I'm going to be doing any more with this this particular model. And if I was going to rank it A to F, let's say, like A, B, C, D, F, I would probably give myself a D, just due to the fact that it's not complete. I'm missing parts. I lost a part, broke some parts. Like I said, this nose, the engine cap or whatever, should be removable. I can't. It's crooked. I don't think I got it the 17 degree angle thing right. Like I said, I'm missing some parts here. The color, it's not a problem. Anyways, I'm just saying it's. But I'm, like I said, I'm not super duper ultra. I'm not happy with it, and it was frustrating as hell. But I'm going to show you something in a minute here. Yeah, so that's really about it. I finished it up. I'm okay with it, is what I'm saying. It'll go on the, it'll go on my war table and sit there. Nothing else really left to tell you. I just did that, more burnt orange here. I used the soft black. I like that, soft black. It just seems to give that rubbery type of a look to it. Oh my God, there's a bazillion mistakes. If you can see, like I said, you can see like some massive blemishes there that I screwed up with and what happened. I'm sorry, I have to do this just for hissy. That's it. Just doing that for hissy. And you know, this thing I had to reuse like a huge chunk of super glue. I don't want to even move it, but you can see it's, it looks screwed up and I'm leaving it screwed up. Well, maybe I'll paint it a little bit. I'll see. But just because I didn't glue it proper. Anyways, I'm okay with it, is what I'm saying. However, I did go to the hobby store yesterday, and I did actually go to it today. I will show you the other plane here. So that was my first one. What a wing size difference. Holy moly. So this, look, oh God. Look how crooked it is. How crooked that is either. Oh my Lord, Lefton. I never knew. So this is an Academy 1-72, and that's the Revell 1-72 Fokker DR1, and that's the Sopwith Camel. I went back yesterday to go get the Academy Spad 8, which I'd seen there before, but it now looks like somebody around my neck of the woods is also a World War I modeling purchaser, because that was missing, or it was purchased, and I went back today to, well, you'll see in a second, I went back today and I just went to go check and the only box of World War I infantry that they used to have, Airfex 1-72, that's gone. So I went, this is neat. Somebody else is into painting World War I. This is cool. So I did go back yesterday and this is the neat thing. So you saw this. And it's actually more of the instructions in me. But I'll put that off to the side. So that's the Revell instruction things. However, so here's the other, so I picked up another Academy Sopwith Camel just so I could practice again and I can do a different paint scheme and maybe do this one historically. However, they had this at the store just as I was about to leave. I'm like, are you kidding me? Sorry, I'll zoom out a bit. So they had the Airfex Fokker DR1 and the Bristol F2B, which I have over here in 1:48 scale. I would like to try it. I want to try it eventually. I think I showed it to you before. This one here, but I'm like, no, I'm not ready for that type of stuff yet. This is the neat thing. So I got another crack at doing the DR1, which I think is really neat. I'm going to do the Bristol first. I can tell you that much. This is the cool thing. I wanted to show you the difference in, I'll have to zoom out as much as I can. There we go. I want to show you the difference in perhaps skill level for the instructions, because it's like, woo, I actually got to see Hissy's P40 Airfex model yesterday on the shelves. I went, oh my gosh. So, oh yeah, of course I've already started washing it. So there's the Fokker DR1 thing. Not a lot of parts, which is really interesting. They both come with pilots. Everybody comes with pilots, which is really nice. And I actually, this time, for the first time in a while, well, first time, I think, well, you know, in quite some time, I went and washed it in warm, soapy water. So that's the Bristol. And what a, look at that. Jesus H, eh? Big, big difference in size. So I've got that dried. And this is what I wanted to show you, this the instruction differences. So maybe it is a skill level difference thing, too. And it was also neat because I was watching a review. One guy was like, oh, you can bang it out in the afternoon, one of these models. And I was like, oh, really? So here's the Revell. And you can see, I'm just going to go through. We'll see how many steps. Oh, I'm going to move that over. I mean, sorry if it's a glare. I can't really see what... I'm just doing my thing here. Hopefully you can see. I'll do that, maybe. But... fair amount of steps. I mean, I'm sure not a lot, but this is the neat thing. I went on the Rodin website today to take a look at their 1-72s because my hobby store said, oh, we can order them if you want. I was like, yes, I want to order. I would like to do a Gotha or something like that, like a big bomber. And then when I saw the parts, because at the Rodin site, I could take a look and I could they had all the parts, like, you know, that picture of the sprues. And I went, nope, not yet. But I picked some other things to try. So there you go. You can see what I mean for the Revell. Now let's take a look at the Bristol. And it's like, holy moly, what a difference. And the Fokker. So there's the, that's it. That is it. Four big panels for the Bristol. And it's over. You're done. So it's, in other words, focus on the painting. Which is exactly here. And then, and here's the Fokker DR1. And that's that. Another four steps. Yet again with these. I don't know what it is the obsession with having the struts go through the middle wing. I don't know why. I wouldn't have it this way, but there must be a reason why modelers... I mean, I've only done two models, so it's like basically shush. They know what they're doing. But this is going to be so neat. I am going to do it, therefore, but I want to do this one much, much. I've wanted to do a two-seater for ages. Well, you know what I mean? Remote... yeah, for ages, let's go for it. Yeah, but it'll be nice to do this one so I can compare later and see also the ease of, like, okay, it was a lot easier, but was it, the only, one thing I'm going to be sad about is no cockpit. I just hit it, that tail thing. Oh, that's the problem, I keep touching that bit. Absolutely adored doing that cockpit. I don't even see it. Just had a lot of fun. I had to glue all the little tiddly bits in there, and yeah, it was just fun. But lots of other parts I didn't enjoy. So, oh yeah, here's the other thing I got today. That'll be it, I think. Yep. I decided to get this. It's just a bare bones airbrush thing. Sorry about the glare yet again. But it was $30 Canadian. It's the compressed air, but I'm hoping to goodness that I couldn't. It's just this one here. It's that was also the same price as the airbrush thing. But I'm hoping I can use. I think it's the same aperture as the as like you know, the computer one. So that'd be fine. And then, yet again, the same stuff I've been using the brush on stuff, but this time I'm going to obviously, but I'm not going to be doing the Bristol tomorrow, probably. I'm going to read up on how to use an airbrush thing, watch maybe the odd YouTube video thing, and also practice on some sprues and whatnot, and go from there, but... I think that's it. That's all I really wanted to say. Yeah, it's going to go downstairs. It's not, it was frustrating. I think sometimes I was looking at him, like, I actually said to myself this afternoon, I was like, you and I were just not made for each other. It's just, that's just the way it is sometimes. But, oh yeah. All right. Hope you're having a great time. See you later.